It was my freshman year in college. I'd been living in Philly for maybe 3 months by this point. And, I didn't know anybody really. So, you know, I had my boyfriend Greg. And then I had my downstairs neighbor Kira. And Greg practically lived at my apartment because I never went anywhere.
Acabei descobrindo que ele era amigo do meu avô.
Kira,
meu avô era mais jovem, morava lá numa área do Rio.
Enfim,
era da idade do meu avô. Aí teve um dia que eu tive que fui pagar o aluguel lá no escritório dele e tinha umas coisas para resolver no apartamento e ele já estava meio que na hora de fechar o expediente. Ele falou para a secretária que podia ir embora.
Confiança nas amigas,
I remember waking up in the middle of the night, thinking, still like your house, dreaming, thinking, oh my god, I'm gonna hurl, I'm gonna throw up, and thinking in the dream, thinking, oh, I feel so sick.
I never even really yelled at him before.
I remember opening my eyes, and he's on top of me. And he is doing something like he'd never done before, which is in the middle of the night, wake up and want to have sex. Not only want to have sex, but not even lead up to it. Just like, on top of me, here we go. I hadn't even digested yet. I could literally taste the beef tips with pasta, you know, in the back of my throat. And I remember saying to him, you know, please, no, God, babe, not right now. You know, you're using all this terminology that you're used to using because, you know, this is your partner. This is the person who you sleep with every night. You know, you trust him. And I remember saying, exactly, and I want to make love with him.
And I said, oh, babe, not right now, because he's really sick. Consintiendo, pero también yo me hubiese quitado mi ropa, ¿no? ¿Por qué amanezco vestida con solo los panties en la sala y las faldas levantadas hasta aquí?
Pero desnuda.
No desnuda, con mi ropa. O sea, yo andaba como
sin panties, con mi falda levantada.
En una cama, piernas abiertas.
That's literally what went through my head at that moment, and what I thought and what I felt. And the next thing, the next part of that, you know, sequence for me is looking at myself from above, and just hanging on to the shapes, going, okay, it's going to be over soon. Just turn your head to the side and just deal with it.
And he was like,
entonces yo le digo, pero
you know,
we had sex. You know,
so you got
to
be offended. And I had just bought a toaster at the table right next to the front door. And
Like, I was washing.
Pero a mí no se me ocurre.
E incluso se llevó, me dice mi hermana, los gringos y la gente que vive en el sur, muy cerca de la frontera con
Juárez. I heard, like,
que las mujeres empezaron a decir, ¿qué no sigues corriendo? Te mato y voy a petir. ¿Por qué me emborraché? ¿Qué pendeja? O sea, las empezaron a
decir,
¿qué fácil? Llego a mi casa. Mi hija estaba cerrada porque son las 5 de la mañana a esta altura. Nosotros salimos.
And I was just like, you just
said
a toaster oven at my head. Like, my toaster oven in the box. You just throw it at me. Like, he could, yeah. I'm like, this could have been very bad for me.
Y cuando yo llego a las 5, mi hija está histérica. Mami, pero ¿dónde tú estabas? Y yo texteándote y tú no me contestas. O sea,
mujeres muertas o desaparecidas.
Mi hija histérica.
High strong.
En ningún momento yo le yo estoy pensando otra cosa que no sea esto es mi culpa. Me emborraché y me acosté con el tipo.
¿Comiste algo de lo que te dio el tipo? O ya mejor te olvidaste.
No, ni yo ni recuerdo si comí lo que le estaba preparando. No, él estaba sirviendo como una bandeja. Yo ni sé. Él me tuvo que llevar a mi casa. Pero tampoco recuerdo ese viaje de su casa a mi casa. La conversación que tuvo. Yo no recuerdo esa conversación. Era como que... Y después por dos días estaba como que vomitando y sonza, me quedaba dormida y como al segundo día, eso fue un domingo, el martes fue cuando yo empecé a decir, esto fue una droga, esto no fue alcohol.
¿Te puedo matar con
esto no fue alcohol.
And I remember thinking, I remember later on, literally separated and ended, thinking,
he bebido más de lo que bebí esa noche.
That was the beginning of me putting myself in a position of second class or somehow unimportant or just something about the mechanism that I employed in that moment of just turning my head to the side and just letting finish doing what I was going to be doing and avoiding that
conflict. Pam cried for help.
Is I think something that remained constant for the rest of its duration. And I thought about it.
But I remember it being such a rough experience.
You know, what I would like, say,
the kind of stuff that I was saying I don't like hair pulling and, you know, just like,
I feel he, like shit, I'm in a hurl on
sweat a lot.
Do you want me
to it would just like,
you know, half,
really
half digested beef tips. Is that what you want on you right now? Because I can assure you it's not going to become, you know, and like, I've thought about that quite a bit as to what would be.
I don't think
and then I realized
on me, but it was
that in that
situation,
no, I would not have
maybe he like spit in
done anything any different because this was the man I was
kissing. But it was just not like
for me was already
had and
one adopting.
In the end, I just
what every woman before me.
It wasn't fun. You
and
know?
No matter how much I told myself,
so
that I was going to be different.
When he
it was the moment
was, taking a shower, or whatever. Afterwards, I walked up to him in the bathroom and I was like, since when do we have rough sex like that? And he was he's really big and, you know, strong. So like,
part of me felt like, cuando las están violando y ella es el estertor de la muerte, les oprimen más el pene a los hombres.
I don't even want to get myself in a panic to where I'm feeling like
contracción
I'm having
vaginal,
to get out of
o sea,
the situation and have him feel
lo,
like,
las mutilaban,
you know,
los senos las quemaban. O sea,
se
ve un odio hacia las mujeres. Un odio terrible. Dices, ¿por qué ese odio tan tremendo? Entonces también pues ha habido muchas campañas porque se ve que las mismas mujeres
estamos
en una sociedad machista que los machos.
Like, you know, I like to
cheguei
have
lá, no, todo mundo não aconteceu o que aconteceu, eu contei,
that's kind of where it ended, but I think about that time a lot because I really
me porque imediatamente
I felt like a very different person from what
e resolvi, like, foi procurar uma amiga, a gente eu mudei na casa da minha amiga, com meu filho e
me mandei do apartamento
e o cara ficava ligando.
My woman doesn't know where I am,
ele,
so I'm going to have,
um
like,
dia
this
secretária
like, I don't know you kind of sex.
Era indignante que reportaram a mulher. Você não lê mais cá, porque ela não vai pagar nada. Porque a gente sabe o que ela fez.
Claro, você não merecia.
E además, os tempos
andavam em para cá
antes que a gente ligue para a polícia. Quem se los manda?
De papo, ela não vai pagar nada.
As mulheres que dizem o mesmo.
To change things without there being discussion or do you like this or whatever.
Entonces te quiero pintar todo el panorama así de cómo se da en mi país una impunidad terrible. Así. Y empiezan a aparecer
más mujeres que yo no le conté esto, que pasé por arriba, que yo estaba, I was not dealing with
it. Estabas en la negación, ¿no?
En la negación total, y ahí es donde yo digo, I was raped, I need therapy, I need to deal with it. Y ahí empiezo entonces a ponerme para el tema de mujercita, que parte de esta violación que me ocurre a mí este año.